Hello again. By now you've begun to get a bit of a taste of what is AudioQuest and how far it's come from when it was a few spools of wire next to the washer and dryer in my garage. I'm the proudest guy on earth for how far it's come, and even more proud of the quality of the people, some of whom you're being introduced today, who make AudioQuest possible. This little thing is called DragonFly. It's the size, looks like a USB stick, a thumb drive, type of thing you plug into your computer that normally all it can do is remember something and feed it back. In this case, it replaces the sound card in your computer, which is something which is free, so you don't need to do anything different, but our whole world, as you'll hear from Mary, other people at AudioQuest, is about lower distortion and the ways in which that increases the quality of the emotional experience that music, audio, dialogue can bring. So this little guy, it's converting the digital files that are stored on your computer into an analog waveform that can then feed your headphones, earbuds, powered speakers, big rig hi-fi system, whatever it is. And all that happens within this tiny little device, which is both efficient for manufacturing. There's no cable attached. In fact, an interesting aspect of the history of this product is that it began life in concept as what I called an intelligent cable, that it should be a USB plug on one end, analog output plugs on the other end, and in between would be some size little box, which would make the conversion from digital to audio. And thanks to the designer that has enabled this product to be all that it is, Gordon Rankin of Wavelength Audio. In one of our early conversations, he suggested, why don't you just make it the size of a USB thumb drive and not have to have a cable? I said, fantastic, you can do that. It's ironic for a cable manufacturer to find it an advantage to not have cable, but it is, because if you attached our best, and it really is good and it really is worth it, if you attached our best $500 USB cable to a DAC, it wouldn't be as good as plugging the DAC in directly. So being the most cost-effective product you can possibly be, rather than trying to sell cable, is actually our agenda, and what makes it fun to bring a product to market. There will be other products in this family later in 2014 into the future. Pieces that will work with mobile devices, be battery powered, have other capabilities. We're gonna have fun now that we're in this category.